Today we shall talk about the clinical trials that involve ranibizumab alone in neovascular AMD. This is not an exhaustive discussion of the details of all the trials, but just a sensitizer. Anchor and Marina were the two pivotal trials which led to the FDA approval in 2006 of ranibizumab for intravitreal injection for AMD. Both were phase 3 multicenter double-blind randomized controlled trials that used a fixed dose regimen of monthly injections for 24 months with two doses of ranibizumab. The Marina trial compared the efficacy of these two doses with sham treatments, and the Anchor trial compared them with photodynamic therapy. Coming to the results of both these trials, very briefly, if you see the percentage of patients who had lost less than 15 letters at 12 months, it was greater than 90% for both doses in both studies. At 24 months, about a quarter of patients for the 0.3 milligram group and a third of patients in the 0.5 milligram group of the Marina trial gained greater than 15 letters, and similar results were seen in the Anchor trial. First alternative strategy to monthly injections was tested in the PIER study. The PIER and EXCITE studies were designed to reduce the number of injections after the first three monthly doses of ranibizumab to a quarterly fixed dose regimen. In the PIER study, once the monthly injections were over, there was a decline in the visual acuity despite the quarterly injections. Hence, the trial was modified in the second year for all patients to receive monthly injections, following which there was an improvement in visual acuity. The EXCITE study compared the PIER type regimen to monthly fixed dosing schedule and obtained similar results of better vision with the monthly injections. In the continued search for regimens to reduce the risk and inconvenience of monthly injections, various studies examined the PRORENATA or PRN protocol, wherein after the first three monthly injections, regular evaluations were conducted with treatment only if necessary. The SAILOR study showed a decreased benefit similar to the PIER study. However, it verified the safety of the 0.5 milligram dose. The PRONTO study was an OCT-guided PRN protocol. In addition to good results in the first year, strict criteria applied in the second year, wherein treatment was given for any degree of qualitative OCT change, resulted in outcomes that were comparable to the Marina and Anchor trials. The SUSTAIN study showed results similar to the SAILOR study, with no clear benefit of the PRN regimen. The Horizon study enrolled patients who had completed 2 years of the Marina and Anchor studies and employed a PRN protocol, which however did not have specified criteria for treatment but was left to the discretion of the treating ophthalmologist. As a result, the results were suboptimal. The Harbor study compared a fixed dose monthly regimen to an OCT-guided PRN protocol for both 0.5 and 2 mg. Both showed meaningful results at 12 months that continued into the second year. The 2 mg dose did not provide additional benefit, though no harm was produced either. So we can see that overall the PRN protocols did not produce the kind of results that were obtained from Marina and Anchor unless very strict retreatment criteria were applied, and people started looking for other protocols. And now we will look at the treat and extend protocols, wherein after the mandatory initial monthly dosing, the intervals between subsequent visits were increased gradually, with an injection being given at each visit. The TREX-AMD was the first trial to compare the treat and extend protocol of ranibizumab to the monthly dosing regimen, with the interval between visits ranging from 4 to 12 weeks, and found that the mean maximum tolerated interval to be approximately 8.5 weeks. The study showed reasonable results and thus showed that this regimen was a useful strategy to follow. The TREND trial involved more than 600 patients with a similar protocol, but the evaluation did not extend beyond 1 year. In both these studies, the results were good, but absolute values for improvement still fell short of the monthly protocols. In the Canadian treat and extend analysis trial, the treat and extend protocol was found to be non-inferior to the monthly regimen, and at 24 months, 73.7% of patients were able to extend the treatment interval to 8 weeks or more.